Hi folks! Welcome to this new tutorial on how to match the sound of your favorite players with Destructor. Following this tutorial, you'll be able to come close to the sound of your favorite players in a few minutes using the Destructor plugin from Bluecat Audio. To follow this tutorial, you'll need your favorite DAW, Destructor, and FreqAnalyst Multi from Bluecat Audio. First, we create an audio track and insert the Bluecat Audio's Destructor plugin as an effect. Let's call this track the Destructor track. Then we create a second track and insert our example source file. Let's call this the source track. For best results, look for an extract that has only the guitar sound in it. In our example, we start with the famous Van Halen intro, "Do You Really Got Me?" Now let's open Destructor and see how we can match the sound just by ears. Van Halen used a guitar with humbucking pickups in the bridge position. So best is to use a guitar with a good humbucker pickup. We use the excellent ESP ST1 Superstrat guitar for this. As far as the amp goes, Van Halen used a Marshall Super Elite head into a basket with Marshall cabinets filled with Greenback and also JBL speakers. So let's listen to the intro now and see how we can approach the sound by ears. So the guitar sound is saturated, slightly panned to the left, but there's also a reverb in there. Let's get that also in our setup, so the end result is really close to the original. To do this, just insert an FX channel and a reverb plugin. In Cubase, we can use the reverence plugin. The plate 80, with a few small mods to it, should do the trick. Be sure to set the descent from the Destructor track to the reverb track, like in our example. In Destructor, let's load a few models to get close to what we are looking for. Here, the best advice I can give you is to listen to a few presets for each model until you come close to the basic grain for the original VH sound. For the preamp, let's use the VH51 new preset. For the Destruction model, we'll start with strong speaker. And for the post-filter section, we'll use the VH51 preset. In your Destructor track, record the same intro you can hear on the Van Halen source track. This is important to listen back and forth between each track and to fine-tune your final sound. I already did this, I will just insert that sample track so we can move on to the next part. First thing we notice when we compare both is that the original Van Halen sound is more aggressive and brighter sounding than ours, with more mid-cut as well. So let's do the same, so we are close to what we'd like to hear. I suggest to follow what I'm doing, switching back and forward to my own and the original track, and then try to do the same at your end. Here it's really important to experiment and check back the original sound until you feel you have something that comes close. Work from top module, the preamp, towards the bottom, and then for the post module we'll use the Blue Cat's excellent FreqAnalyst multi to fine-tune our sound. So in the preamp module, let's tweak the bass, mid and tone controls a little bit, just like this. Then in the Destruction module, let's get a little bit more drive. Maybe also a little bit more dynamics. If you click on the E and plus buttons at the right side of the Destruction module, you see you can open the full editor. This is really handy to dive more into details. Let's increase smooth and rectify controls and put oversampling at 4 for even better results. A few minor tweaks can really change the whole shape of your distortion sound here. Then in the post filter section, let's cut some mid and boost some treble. Same here, click on the E button to open the editor of the post filter section. This section is very important to fine tweak your final sound. Once you have a sound that starts to get close, load the FreqAnalyst multi plugin on the master track. Choose Channels Average from the pop-up menu. Set precision to 8 and start analyzing the original Van Halen intro sound. Best is to reset average right after the track begins playing, like I do here. Then click on A at the right end of the plugin menu to memorize the curve. This gives you a nice view of the spectrum of the guitar sound, which helps us to further tweak our custom preset sound. Now do the same for the Destructor track and click on B when finished listening. This should give you two different curves. As you can see, there are a few parts in our second curve, the orange one, that is different from the first red one. While it's impossible to get exactly the same result, we'll try to get as close as possible. We do the last steps a few times until you get close to the original curve, like in our example. So let's add some more low end here. And some more air in the higher frequencies. Let's add some more definition in the lower and mid range. this is getting better.
Yep, some more low end here.
Also play a little bit with the comb filter, that orange icon here. The comb filter makes it possible to add some natural phase effects you also get from normal microphone setups. Keep in mind that the original Van Halen sound was mastered, so you can also throw in a dynamics plugin or even another EQ to tweak the sound even further. But for our tutorial, I think this is okay. Hope you liked this tutorial. Thanks and keep rocking!